We're back here at the National Firearms Museum here at NRA headquarters. I'm with Phil Schreier, Senior Curator at the National Firearms Museum. Phil, gorgeous. Four long guns here. What do we have?
Well, John, you know, it's all over the news. This is the 150th anniversary of the Civil War, 1861, 2011. Susquecentennial, they call it.
Oh, very good.
150. Can't spell it and hardly pronounce it, but the sentiment is there. And to commemorate that, we have added a set of guns to the collections here that are just absolutely remarkable. They were completed in 1990 by Holland and Holland, famous gun makers in England. And it's called the American Civil War Set. And there are four Holland & Holland 12-gauge Royal Grade shotguns, side-by-sides. And each one represents, you know, a year of the four-year-long, well, this side of the Mason-Dixon, we call it the War Between the States.
Yes,
but,
sir.
The American Civil War. And the Bellino engraving on each one of these, executed by Philippe Griffiny, a famous Belgian engraver working in England, is just really exquisite.
Oh, it sure is.
In fact, we have art imitating art in one of them. You know, a famous war correspondent of the Civil War was Winslow Homer,
yes.
Who later became a very famous American painter. But one of his most compelling images is that of the of the U.S. sharpshooter sitting in a tree with a canteen hanging off a branch. And that work of art by Homer is recreated here on the receiver of the of one of the Holland & Hollands.
Wow.
Each panel, both right and left side, represents a different and yet significant scene of the late War of the Rebellion, as others call it. Here we have a portrait of John Brown, who tried to get things started off a little early in 1851 in Harper's Ferry, Virginia.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's in West Virginia today. Another part of the Civil War history is how that happened. But
yes,
on the receiver, this one we have Marsh Robert E. Lee, the commander of the Army in Northern Virginia. Native of Virginia, offered the command of the Union Army by Winfield Scott, turned it down, said he would not draw his sword against his native state.
Mm-hmm.
His wife's ancestral home was seized and taken by the Yankees, a home that had belonged to George Washington's,
right.
You know, grandchildren, and now is Arlington Cemetery.
Yes.
Lee's counterpart in blue, Ulysses S. Grant, not only commander of all the Union armies, but also right prior to the time of his death, president of the National Rifle Association.
Mm.
And then on this last
number
piece
four.
Here, Abraham Lincoln, as sculpted by Daniel French at the Lincoln Memorial, as
wow.
He's seen today in Washington.
Incredible.
And just wonderful little scenes. Artillery on the Knoll at Gettysburg. Beautiful rendition of the last scene of the war.
Hmm.
Grant and Lee meeting together in Wilbur McLean's house at Appomattox. So wonderful stories of the, you know, depicted on each of the four shotguns. And neat thing about it, it's in a beautiful federal style wooden case that was actually made by Holland & Holland as well. And it comes with all the accoutrements, pull-out drawers, cases for the set. You know, the value of the set is you know, nearly seven figures. It's one of the most beautiful four-gun sets ever made.
Wow. And it's here at the National Firearms Museum. Amazing.
A little bit of Civil War history via England and back here again.
I guess
again.
By then England finally decided that we were going to probably make it on our own, and they decided, you know, Holland, it'd be okay to.
Yeah.
Well, Phil, beautiful stuff. How do folks come and see these? And I dare I say, if you can get here in person, I'm just sitting here looking at these. They're just exquisite.
For right now, that's the only way to appreciate these. We just put them out on exhibit. Hopefully, we'll have them up on the internet soon.
Right. Well, of course, we'll get that
but
done
for
as well.
Right now, you definitely need to come and see us during the sesquicentennial events for the next 4 years at the National Firearms Museum, exit 57A off Interstate 66, just outside of Washington, D.C., in Fairfax, Virginia. Open 7 days a week, 9:30 to 5. Free admission, plenty of parking. On the internet, we're at nramuseum.org.
Yeah, what a great way to come to talk about the Civil War in this area with the National Firearms Museum, Manassas, all the battlegrounds around. You talked about Arlington. This is where so much of it happened, and this is such a great addition to this capital area, sort of, you say it, Phil.
Sesquicentennial.
There you go. Phil Schreier, thank you very much for another fascinating installment of the Curator's Corner.
Thank you, John, for having us as always.